Capital Network's Ed Stacey is with me on the line. Ed, good morning. Good to speak to you.
Good morning, Andrew.
Ed, Plastics Capital, we're talking about, announced a share placing today. Tell me a bit more.
Yes, so as you know, Plastics Capital, specialist plastics manufacturer in various niche markets. And yeah, it's a major announcement this morning. They're issuing 3.2 million shares. So this is a conditional placing. They say that's oversubscribed. And those shares would amount to about 9% of the existing market cap, so it's a material capital raising. The money they're going to use partly for CapEx investments. They said in their previous trading update that they had some big order flow, you know, some big expansion in parts of their businesses, and that would involve CapEx. So part of the money is going towards that effort, and then partly it's increasing their minority holding in a business called CCM, which is a U.S. business that's been going well as well, so they want to increase the holding. And then finally, they've announced that they are suspending the dividend payment in order to use every bit of capital they can towards these expansion efforts.
Let's come back in a moment to that dividend announcement, Ed. First off, though, as you say, using this cash towards increasing capacity and accelerating growth. Tell me a bit more about those growth opportunities.
Yes, I mean, firstly, the sort of internal organic growth. They had a statement out on May the 2nd. They highlighted there that they'd been getting some very strong business flow. They mentioned particularly their bearings business and something called mandrels, which is to do with how you manufacture hoses. And that's partly because of the weakness in sterling that you'd had during 2016 has given them some more opportunities. And partly it's just that those businesses are just doing very well at finding new business. So they'd been talking about more CapEx, about expanding those businesses. And so no surprise, you know, the part of the use of the capital raising is to go ahead with those expansions. And then the external part of the expansion, this business CCM, so that's channel creasing matrix. It's a business in the U.S. Now, a creasing matrix, it's something that Plastics Capital is already involved in. They're one of the two big players. Creasing matrix is a type of plastic strip that's used in the manufacture of cardboard boxes. So it's a small niche business, but there's basically two big players in the world. Plastics Capital is one of them. This business CCM is something a year ago in the U.S. they bought a 10% stake in CCM, which is a manufacturer and a distributor of these creasing matrix products. So it was expanding Plastics Capital's reach in the U.S. Now they've had a year to look at this with the 10% holding. They've realized there's more synergy opportunities both on the manufacturing side and the distribution side. So they want to raise that stake up to 49%. And it looks to us like that is earnings accretive, EPS accretive from the get-go. So it's a, you know, it's an acquisition that's all to the good in terms of earnings growth.
Now, Ed, you mentioned a little earlier about the suspension of the dividend payment. We're talking the next two dividend payments, are we?
Yes. So that will be what would have been the year-end March 2017 final dividend, and then the interim dividend for the next financial year. Now, they haven't specified then when will they restart the dividend or how much will it be. But I've assumed in my models that it's going to be rebased downwards and that they will recommence with a final dividend payment at the end of year March 2018. So two dividends they will miss. And I think it does make sense. I mean, if you're raising capital and then paying that same capital straight back out again, it's just not good capital management. If you have these growth opportunities, if you're going to use the cash for that, well, then, you know, let's be sensible about the dividend policy. So I think it's a decision that it's consistent with what they're trying to do in terms of growth.
A sensible decision, you say there. Ed, look, final thoughts then on today's developments from Plastics Capital.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously moves that are aimed at cementing their path for growth going forward and sort of guaranteeing that they achieve the growth. It's obviously, you know, it's been oversubscribed, the placing, so some big institutions have looked at this and thought, yep, this seems like a good idea, we want to subscribe. And yet you're buying the shares now on, it's back below 10 times PE, so, you know, it's still good value here. So I know some investors out there will feel, you know, with the lack of a dividend that, you know, that puts them off, but I think you've actually got to look at it as a growth story and, you know, a decent valuation. I think it's an interesting time to look at Plastics Capital.
Very good, Ed. Thanks very much indeed. Ed Stacey, Capital Networks analyst.